Welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna make some sweet little treats. First up, we've got an almond and choc slice. So you're gonna wanna preheat your oven. Now, I like to make these sorts of treats because other people don't know they're the healthy version. So take 1 cup of almond butter. Then 1/4 cup of applesauce. 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, and stir that all together. Then in a separate bowl, we're gonna mix our dry ingredients. So we have 1.5 teaspoons of baking soda, about 1/2 cup of sorghum flour, and then 1/8 cup of some sort of natural sugar alternative. So I'm using Natvia here. Now you get to choose, do you want dark chocolate or do you want cacao? Pick which one you prefer and then mix that into the dry mix. Now we're going to pop the dry into the wet and then stir that all together. Line or grease a baking tray. These sorts of treats are great for if you're visiting like friends or family, you've got them coming over and they're not the sort of people that want to eat healthy food. They prefer the very sweet, very unhealthy version of snacks. They probably won't be able to tell the difference. Now we're going to pop that in the oven for 10 to 15 minutes. When you remove it from the oven, let it cool down, and before you serve them, let it cool completely. Otherwise they will fall apart. They taste really good if you reheat them before you serve them though, just so the chocolate can melt a little bit more. Now we're gonna make some coconut date balls. This one is really easy, you just need a food processor, so I'm throwing in 400 grams of dried pitted dates, and then I'm gonna turn on the food processor so they can start being chopped apart. Once they've been in for a little while, I'll add in 2 really large handfuls of almonds. You could also add cashews if you prefer. Now I'm gonna take some coconut nectar. You can find this in health food stores. That's a liquid sweetener, but it's a little bit better for you. Pop that in, the mix will start to stick together, and then I'm gonna add 2 teaspoons of cocoa powder. You could use cacao powder as well. When it looks like this, it's ready for you to roll into balls of whatever size you prefer, and then I like to roll it in desiccated coconut afterwards before I serve it. It helps stop them from sticking together as well. Now finally, I call these breakfast bites just because they're really good for breakfast and they have oats in them. So again, make sure your oven is on. I actually cooked both of mine at the same time, but that's the same piece of footage. Now I'm gonna cut up 12 pitted dates. And in a bowl, combine the dates and 1/2 cup of applesauce or mashed banana. I had no ripe bananas, so the applesauce will do. 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. 1/2 cup of shredded oats. And then grab a whole bunch of frozen raspberries or frozen strawberries or blueberries or whatever kind of berry you would like. Mix it together. If you're finding that the mixture is a little too wet and doesn't hold together, add in 1 few extra shredded oats. Now you're gonna scoop that out onto a baking tray, and I like to leave them sort of 3D, not completely flat, and then I'll bake them for 15 minutes. When you pull them out, just let them cool a little bit, but they're good to go pretty much straight away. And that's them. I hope you guys enjoy these sweet, healthy treat options. Let me know which one you want to try in the comments below, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Bye!